I Love Dogs presents the Shiba Inu.
A willful, loving,
independent, bratty,
aloof,
stubborn,
cat-like,
charming,
great dogs.
The Shiba Inu is a native of Japan and was bred originally for hunting. The Shiba is a bold, intelligent, independent breed. Once people own this agile, funny, silly dog, they generally never look back.
They have to kind of know dogs, I think, because they could be really quirky, and they could be independent, they could be stubborn, they could be aloof. You kind of have to know what you're doing with a Shiba. You've got to be trained from the time they're puppies. Otherwise, they can and will take over your house. And he's older than every dog here. He's an old man. He loves it. He loves being here. He loves everybody. He's a really good specimen of a Shiba. He's been a therapy dog. He's not aloof. He loves people. He loves places. You can't ask for more than that.
You should be pretty strong with them. You know, they can be a willful dog. Get one early. I'd say 6, 7 weeks old, maybe 8 weeks old. And get them used to other dogs and people. A lot of handling. And they're wonderful dogs. They're great dogs. But you have to control them. Because they're a hunting breed, they have a really strong prey drive. If they grow up with a cat or bird, they're usually very good with them. We have a cat and we have 3 Shibas and they get along pretty well. This is the most beautiful girl in the world.
Health-wise, the Shiba is genetically sound overall.
General Shibas do tend to live fairly long lives. They're not a large dog, and so they tend to mature a little bit slower. So your typical Shiba, provided they're healthy, would live to at least 10 years, if not older.
Its short coat and desire to remain clean make grooming the Shiba a breeze. However, the Shiba does blow its coat twice a year, which means it'll shed a lot, but daily brushing can help.
In order to keep your Shiba's coat looking good on a regular basis, I suggest bathing, perhaps not more than once weekly, and regular brushing with a soft-coated brush. In addition, you could use an omega-3 fatty acid supplement like fish oil or flaxseed. For your typical healthy dog that might need supplementation beyond what their dog food is providing for them, you could use the I Love Dogs multi-purpose supplement. It's going to give vitamins, minerals, antioxidants.
The Shiba's independent nature makes him not so great in the obedience ring, but puppies are generally very easy to house train.
Shibas are very trainable on leash, and they should be well behaved in the house, but it's not an off-leash breed. None of the Nordic dogs are really good off-leash. They tend to run away, but that doesn't mean they can't be really good house pets and good on leash. Sociability with other dogs depends on the Shiba. The Shibas that are being bred in the United States are much friendlier and more mild and less dog aggressive than the ones that were bred in Japan and imported initially when the breed came here. They're bratty dogs. It could be in a funny, charming way. They're not obedient the way a golden is obedient. They'll try to do stuff to get you to chase them or to get you to laugh. And I had a Shiba and I was editing my book. I'd get up to go get a cup of tea and he would sit on the manuscript when I came back. He'd get on the desk and he'd sit exactly where I was reading. And I knew what he wanted. He wanted me to say, "You brat," and chase him all over the house. And instead of doing that, what I did is I lifted up a paw at a time and I kept editing. And it made him furious because he couldn't get what he wanted was a good chase. So they're that kind of bratty. They're not, you know, bratty horrible.
Shiba Inu is an interesting breed of dog, very cat-like, quite honestly. There can be some challenges with training Shiba Inus or with their behavior. The challenge that I see most often with them is that it's really hard to get them to focus. So when you're trying to educate a dog, if you can't get it to focus, it's hard to teach it what you want it to do. But it's kind of typical for the breed. They'll look past you or they'll look through you. They won't give you that direct focus where you can actually teach the dog or guide the dog to show it an acceptable behavior. Very aloof, kind of cat-like breed, but they are very, very sweet dogs. Once you can get their focus and attention, they can be extremely loving family companions.